cream of it.
Today on Inside Stuff, Ahmad Rashad gets some thoughts on the playoffs from Kevin Garnett of the Timberwolves.
That's why they're here.
We're inventing a new dance move.
Call it the web now.
Plus in Fit Facts, Derek Fisher puts Summer Sanders through her paces in a Lakers agility workout.
You cannot believe what we just saw.
I'm here to show you some of my flashes. Move.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Inside Stuff. Starting now, it's a brand new season in the NBA. The playoffs are here. And by the way, you're looking at the brand new uniform of the Cleveland Cavaliers. DeJuan Wagner's number. Now, they're not in the playoffs, so, but if they were in the playoffs, this is what they'd be wearing. They're not in the playoffs, so you see them wearing this next year. Anyway, getting back to the playoffs, for the past six seasons, Minnesota hasn't made it out of the first round. This year, good news, bad news. The Timberwolves have home court advantage for the first time, but they face the defending champion Lakers. Either way, Kevin Garnett is on a mission to make sure that history does not repeat itself.
I don't like sitting home for my birthday in May. You know, I want to hoop. I don't work out from June to September to go home in May. You know, I'm in it for the long haul. I'm dedicated to however, whenever. And, I can't even put that into words on how much hurt it's like. It's like you in middle school and, you know, that fine girl that you finally had a conversation with comes up to you and she dumps you on the site in front of all your boys. And the feeling you got in your stomach is like, you know, I can't believe, you know, that just happened. That's what it's like going out the first round over and over and over. Like, you know, I just keep happening to me, you know? You know, are you serious right now? This cannot be happening. That's what it's like. And so to get over that, man, it'd be so. You know? And I'm not gonna sit here and say, I wanna go to the second round. I wanna get to the finals. And that might be kind of, you know, people watching this might be like, you know, one step at a time. No. No. I've been through that one step program, it's not for me. I need to get to the second and then focus on the third and hope, you know. You know, I'm a big dreamer. And I feel like the only way you can really, 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 really believe something is if you can see it. And, you know, I've been fortunate to, live my dream and playing in the NBA. So, you know, it's definitely possible. But, you know, dreams are made to be reality. So this is my reality, so I know. And I'm dreaming about a ring that someday it's going to be my reality. Believe that. Oh, I can see it. I can see it. I can see it. I can see it so much I can feel it. I can sit here and go play by play with you. I can see it. You know? It's kind of woos you on. You know, what players is what, you know, what teams, whatever, but I can see me clear. I can see me so clear.
While you're watching the playoffs, be prepared to see a familiar face in an unfamiliar place. Five-time All-Star Tim Hardaway spent most of this season in a TV studio. But now he's back in the NBA with Indiana, injecting his own kind of energy into the Pacers' playoff run.
Hey, hold on there. Just because I'm recently retired don't mean y'all forgot about my clutch shots.
Why you wanna test me? Why you wanna test me? Never test this skill. Why you wanna test me? Don't test this skill. Why you wanna test me? Don't test this skill.
I got skill. That's me right there.
Oh, everybody knows I'm back. Everybody knows I can play. And I still have skills.
After 13 years in the league, Tim spent most of this season as an analyst on NBA broadcast. But when the Pacers came calling in late March, Tim was ready.
Here's Hardaway for another switch in a groove. He hasn't played all season. His first game back Hardaway is in 4 3-pointers tonight.
Oh, I can shoot the ball. I can still put the ball in the hoop. There's no question about that.
And they officially welcome Tim Hardaway as a Pacer. Could not ask for anything better tonight.
You know, this was one of the teams I thought I could help with experience coming off the bench and just running the show, giving them confidence out there, getting the ball to the right people at the right time, and at the end of games, just making sure that we win.
On a young team, Tim is one of the few players who actually knows what it takes to win, along with fellow veteran Reggie Miller.
Only one I could really relate to is Reggie. We the eldest on the team, and we can relate to each other by, you know, how many years we played in the league.
Well, it's good to talk to the 30-somethings on the teams. And it's good to actually talk old-school hoops with Tim.
It's just a bunch of young guys now, 22, 21, 24, 25 years old. But they're doing a great job.
Just his savvy, his experience, his understanding of situations out on the floor, that will be a big value to us going into the playoffs.
I wanted to be on a playoff team. That's where the fun is. That's where the excitement is at. This team has a lot of confidence, a lot of athleticism, and I think we go for it.
What's up? This is Justin Timberlake, and I want the inside stuff.
Coming up is skill. Richard Jefferson of the New Jersey Nets breaks down the basics of driving to the hoop.
We'll save the dunk for the next lesson. See you.
And in jam session, music by Justin Timberlake, moves by players all around the NBA.
Monster jam by Kmart.
Now that's the inside stuff.
NBA Inside Stuff on ABC is brought to you by Sprite, Obey It Thirst, and Nike.com.
Yo, Mars Black here, and my main man Michael Jordan on a speed dial. No money, it's me.
Who?
Me.
Who?
Me. From back in the day.
Mars?
Yeah. Is this really it?
You're gonna retire?
Calling it quits?
Is it true?
Yes, Mars.
You sure?
Yes, Mars.
Really? Truly?
Cross your heart, hope to die, stick a needle in your eye?
Yes, Mars.
Call me back in 5, doing a commercial, Mr. Nike. You gonna hang him up? You be playing golf? No baseball, though.
I'll even dirt sayonara.
Adios.
Adidasing.
So long.
Goodbye.
Farewell.
For good.
Again?
Goodbye, Mars.
You can be fast, or you can be strong. Or you can find a way to be both. With my thirst, doing whatever it takes.
It's about that time.
What's yours?
It's about that time.
Paul Pierce, All-Star forward.
Jerry Rice, 12 Pro Bowls.
Eric Winalda, 3 World Cups.
When you're the best, you play the best.
The infusion from Spalding.
What's the infusion? It's a pump inside the ball.
It's always ready to play.
No needles, no pumps.
No problems.
Forget these.
Perfect balance.
No flat ball.
No flat game.
Just twist, pump, lock.
You can play. The new line of infusion game balls from Spalding.
Play the best.
Play Spalding.
Miss Lewis.
It is Miss, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Could you tell me again how you use 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls?
Well, I just dialed down the center.
With what, Miss Lewis? With what?
You dialed down the center with 1-800-CALL-ATT. It's free for you, cheap for them.
So good.
Are you sure this guy's a cop?
Save on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Thanks for making me a fighter. Tuesday, what's a father to do when his daughter wants to start dating?
Do you really think in 6 months I'll be better prepared to date?
No, but I'll be better prepared.
8 simple rules. Then Jim Belushi and Dan Aykroyd go back to when it all started.
Are you from Tennessee?
Because you're the only 10 I see.
Catch one full hour of According to Jim. Then, for everyone who's ever worked too much and lost touch with their family...
So you had to ask Mama on a date, huh?
She said yeah.
Your wife said yes?
Yeah.
Hey, all right.
The hit comedy Lost at Home, Tuesday on ABC.
Be sure to tune in all weekend long for the opening round of NBA Playoffs 2003. Coverage begins today at noon Eastern on ESPN with the Bucks against the Nets. That'll be followed at 3 o'clock by Boston and Indiana, and at 5:30 by the Suns against the Spurs. Then coverage shifts to TNT for a nighttime doubleheader. It's Portland and Dallas at 8 o'clock Eastern, and the Jazz against the Kings at 10:30. First round action continues tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern, with the Magic against the Pistons on ESPN. Then coverage begins at 3 o'clock Eastern on ABC for the defending champion Lakers against the Timberwolves. And at 8 o'clock, it's the Hornets against the Sixers on TNT.
Playing in the Western Conference, Derek Fisher of the Lakers has to face a great point guard just about every night. Stephon Marbury, John Stockton, Mike Bibby, just to name a few. And now his assignment is the super quick Troy Hudson of the Timberwolves. In Fit Facts, Derek showed me how he shapes up for the challenge. All right, I'm here with Derek Fisher of the L.A. Lakers, and you are leading the run-and-gun offense of Lakers in the Western Conference, and you've got the whole season almost behind you. Playoffs are upon us.
Yes.
How do you stay in good shape and agility shape and speed work? What do you do?
Well, agilities are extremely important in basketball, and one of the things that we use as a team is the quick foot ladder. We use this to get warmed up, go through a bunch of agility drills, get our footwork together. Right now, I'm about to show you how it's done. So let's pick up the pace.
Did I use this on the dance floor at all?
Summer's pretty good at this.
Oh, my gosh. Right now I'm thinking about speed, but really you should also be concerned about doing it correctly, right?
Yeah. Don't be, you know, bothered by the fact that if you have to start out slow, learn how to do it correctly, and then you can pick up the pace.
You've got some more contraptions for me, don't you?
Yeah.
So this looks fun.
Yeah, this is one of our resistance core drills. This is one of the things that we do to work on explosiveness, work on our lateral movement. See, gotta be able to change direction.
Excellent. So how long do you normally do this?
It varies, you know. During the season, maybe like 30 seconds max. Sometimes in the off season, up to 45 seconds. But this is really tough, and I'm out of breath.
All right, well, I'm willing to give it a try.
All right, let's get you. Let's get you going
any,
here.
Any words of advice for me?
Keep your eye on the ball. Stay low. There you go.
I feel like you're going slow on me.
Yeah, huh? I'm going to start you off slow.
Okay,
and then we're going to pick it up. We're going to pick it up.
Oh, my gosh.
We're going to pick it up. We're going to pick it up.
Oh,
we're going to pick it up.
Start over.
Okay, Summer, this is one of our last drills that we do to end the day. A lot of times you're tired, you're fatigued. These are our hurdle jumps. As you can see, these aren't real regular size hurdles.
I'm so glad.
But really important in basketball, you have to be able to hit the floor and get right back up off the ground.
You guys are wearing me down.
Yeah, I mean, these drills are extremely important. I'm a little guy, so I have to be able to move really quickly.
He's got good quickness. He's really got a knack for coming up with the ball.
These drills that we did today really helps me to stay ready and focused and in shape to be ready for the playoffs.
Derek Fisher, so excited to watch you.
Thank
I'm
going
to go work on this bungee thing. Okay.
Good job. I'll let you handle that. I'll go get some rest.
Okay.
In Rewind, there are only 16 teams left, and the season has a whole new look. Speaking of new looks, Donyell Marshall and Kwame Brown let it all hang out while Kobe Bryant finds a new way to amaze the crowd. Plus, Stromile and Matrix know how to finish, while C-Web finishes just in the nick of time in the latest edition of Rewind. Hey, there's my main man, Dick Bavetta, getting ready for Rewind. Friday, Mike Dunleavy sends it the other way.
Oh, Mike Dunleavy.
This fan's getting down while John Marion gets up on the sun's break. The griller, well, he loved that one. And how about this slick game winner by C-Web?
Weber.
Oh, and you don't like that? You don't like Kings basketball? I like it. Saturday, Kwame Brown goes retro, while MJ goes old school.
Oh, that's vintage Michael Jordan baseline.
Some guys will do anything to get on the floor, while Stevie Francis gets way off the floor on this one.
How does a point guard get that high?
Sunday, the Diesel shows off some finesse.
A finger roll inside for O'Neal.
Yeah, you won't believe your eyes when you see this dunk by Milwaukee's Desmond Mason.
Out Desmond Mason, wind up and throw it down.
Yeah, hey, how about this fan? Hey, how about Kobe against the Blazers?
Kobe Bryant, they gave him an avenue.
Like that.
Oh, found it.
But Rasheed Wallace gets the final word. Take that.
Rasheed Wallace, that might be a winner. He got it.
Monday, fans were drumming up some support for Seattle's Ray Allen.
Oh, my, look where he's got that throw. And he hit it, a 40-foot.
Ooh, Ray has no range. Tuesday, Hey, Powell gets fancy, and Strowmile slams it home.
Tracks it down mile high and throwing it down.
Yeah, Danielle's got the do, but not the moves. And speaking of moves, here's my main man, Jamal Crawford.
Leader, wow, I got this crowd pretty excited with that move.
His jersey is just a little tight. Juwan Wagner, he's a little smaller now. Anyway, finally, the Utah Jazz have made the playoffs for the 20th straight year, but it seems that their history goes back a lot further than that. After playing the Jazz, Celtics coach Jim O'Brien had this to say about 41-year-old John Stockton and Karl Malone, who will turn 40 in July. They're a half-court offense machine. The two of them have been playing together since the 18th century. I don't know whether that's true or not, but there's a rumor that their first game of two-on-two came against Lewis and Clark. You know, Lewis and Clark, the pioneers that came out and discovered the Northwest, Lewis and Clark, way back a long time ago. See, it's a way of him saying that these people were old. It was funny when I heard that earlier today. We'll be back with more stuff right after this. Still kind of funny if you know who Lewis and Clark are.
NBA Inside Stuff on ABC is brought to you by RBK and Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade, is it in you?
Tradition.
A look on the other guy's face.
To be my own Manning.
Being a woman.
Because last year, couldn't.
Millions of little girls.
Every athlete is fueled by something.
Gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology. Better than he was before. Better. Stronger. Faster. A new AOL for broadband. Welcome to the World Wide
Wow.
Wednesday, Damon's son is in love with a girl no one approves of.
Aw, look how stupid he is.
My Wife and Kids, ABC Wednesday.
Based on the beloved Eloise books and ABC world premiere.
I'm Eloise. I'm 6.
Be the guest of the Plaza Hotel's most mischievous resident.
What could possibly go wrong?
But all she's trying to do...
What are you up to?
Nothing.
...is make dreams come true. Jeffrey Tambor, Christine Baranski, Sophia Vasilieva, and Oscar winner Julie Andrews.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Eloise at the Plaza, Sunday, April 27th on ABC.
Inside Stuff wants
you.
It's time to show us your stuff. Inside Stuff wants you to give us your best shot. If you're between the ages of 7 and 17, send us a tape no longer than 30 seconds showing us your best basketball shot. It can be in a gym, on the playground, or even on a junior hoop in your basement.
Come on!
Give it a try.
Your tape might air on national TV. You could be in an Inside Stuff feature playing horse against an NBA or WNBA player.
Did that go in?
And also write an article for Inside Stuff magazine. Log on to NBA.com for official rules and information about how to enter.
During his 11 years in the NBA, Walt Williams of the Mavericks has been known as the Wizard for his magical ability to fill up the scoring column. But growing up, the Wizard got a dose of reality when trying out for his high school team, as he tells us in Back in the Day.
It's a funny story. Originally, how I got started playing was one day I came home from a tryout when I was in high school. And when I came home, it was real dark outside. All my friends were gone. So I was like, man, this basketball taking up too much of my time. So I didn't go back the next day. because I wanted to hang out with my friends, and my sister just went off on me and forced me to go back, basically, and try out. But I got into a little trouble fighting in school, got suspended. So as a result, when I came back, it was 15 guys on the team already, so it was only 15 uniforms, so I had to be the water boy for the first half of the season. So, you know, I'm wiping up sweat, giving guys water, you know, doing the whole nine, just hating it. You know, first of all, I didn't even want to be out there, first of all, because I wanted to hang out and things like that. But halfway through the season, when grades came out, we had 10 guys cut off the team, so that's how I got my chance. And when those 10 guys were gone, we only had 5 guys left, so they gave me a uniform to be a sub off the bench. You know, I persevered. You know, I never gave up, even though I was the water boy. You know, I still had my goals and focus, and I felt like, you know, sooner or later I'm gonna get a chance, and when I do, I'm gonna take advantage of it. So that would be my message. You know, anything that's worth achieving that you're aspiring to do, it's gonna be some obstacles, but if you really wanna do it, you gotta overcome, you gotta persevere, and, you know, good things will happen.
The Boston Celtics have a long history of great point guards, legends like Bob Cousy, JoJo White, Tiny Archibald, and Dennis Johnson. But this season, the Celtics let an undrafted rookie play point guard, J.R. Bremer. You might not know his name, but as the playoffs begin, you're sure to hear about his game.
Who's J.R. Bremer?
Who is this guy? Where'd this guy come from?
First name, J.R., last name, Bremer. 6'2 point guard, Boston Celtics. Undrafted rookie.
J.R. Bremer. In your face, says J.R. Bremer. Bremer's jumper, dagger! Has he been incredible or what?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 2002 NBA Draft.
I played against a lot of guys that got drafted in both rounds, and I always thought my name was going to come after their name got called, and it just never came.
But JR got a tryout with the Boston Celtics, and he made the most of it.
We really liked his ability to shoot the deep ball, and we were in need of some depth at the point guard position. And he's really done a great job for us. Not only did he make our team, but he eventually assumed, as everybody knows, a starting job.
J.R. Bremer, what a great story this kid is becoming.
From day one, he was one of those players that really didn't back down from anybody. You know, you could come into this league and easily get ran out of it, you know, if you don't have any confidence, especially from a kid who hasn't been drafted, who nobody knows about, and you know, he stays hungry.
This kid just gets better and better every week.
When you hear guys like Shaquille O'Neal, I think there was a foul or something. Me and Shaquille are standing next to each other on the lane, and Shaquille looks over and say, "Who is this guy?" You know, so he was shooting pretty good that game.
Hand back to Bremer around the screen. Nice looking shot by the rookie.
As long as he's doing things like that and people are recognizing him, we think he's doing a great job for us.
It's the playoffs. It's the East. Now we know we're in the playoffs.
We know it'll be a change for him. The playoff atmosphere is totally different than the regular season.
They talk about the playoffs in the locker room sometimes and talk about how much harder it is and how the fans are so wild in all the cities. So I'm thinking about it a little bit, but it's wide open. Every team can beat everybody, so you have to come focused.
In gym session, we have collected the best of this week's action during the race for the final playoff position. The song is Rock Your Body by Justin Timberlake. You know, Justin Timberlake, big friend of the show. He was at the, you know, the All-Star game. He's always, you know, he's a main man. Here it is in jam session.
Don't be so quick to walk away.
Weber!
I don't mean
no way!
Just
on Inside Stuff. Shaq meets Baby Shaq. Seventh grader Ari Allen is big in L.A.
12. My goodness, man. Shaquille O'Neal, too.
Plus, in Fit Fact, Sacramento's Bobby Jackson shows Summer some of his sweetest steps.
Once I jab it, free up.
Yeah.
And in Jam Session, talk about sweet, we'll bring you all the top plays from the first week of the NBA playoffs.
Blake on the reverse and one.
Paul Pierce, all-star forward.
Jerry Rice, 12 Pro Bowls.
Eric Winalda, 3 World Cups.
When you're the best, you play the best.
The infusion from Spalding.
What's the infusion? It's a pump inside the ball.
It's always ready to play.
No needles, no pumps.
No problems.
Forget these.
Perfect balance.
No flat ball.
No flat game.
Just twist.
Pump.
Lock.
Can play. The new line of infusion game balls from Spalding.
Play the best.
Play Spalding.
Why do I work so hard? So I can play even harder. What's my thirst? Staying on top. What's yours? I love my job.
Yo, Mars Block here, and my main man Michael Jordan on the speed dial. No money, it's me.
Who?
Me.
Who?
Me. From back in the day.
Mars?
Yeah. Is this really it?
You're gonna retire?
Going to quit? Is it true?
Yes, Mars.
You sure?
Yes, Mars.
Really? Truly? Cross your heart, hope to die, stick a needle in your eye?
Yes, Mars.
Call me back in 5, doing a commercial, Mr. Nike. You gonna hang him up? You be playing golf? No baseball, though. I'll even dirt sayonara. Adios. I'll be the thing. So long. Goodbye. Farewell. Oh, good. Again?
Goodbye, Mars.
We're gonna give the ball to Detroit. Bird steals it. Johnson. Kobe Bryant on the move against Christie. In for the right, flips his shot up, no good. O'Neal lays it up, missed it. Ball tipped out to Oria, straight on three. Good! The Lakers have won!
Lakers, T-Wolves, Sunday 3 Eastern on ABC Sports.
Step through, bust out, bump.
That's it, that's a hook shot.
And now you know how to pass.
Hi, I'm Richard Jefferson from the New Jersey Nets, and today I'm going to show you how to drive to the hoop. First thing when you're driving to the hoop, you got to have a quick first step, that initial boost to get you past the defender coming your way.
The first step is dangerous.
With your first step, you have to cover a lot of ground. You have to be able to use that first step to get past your defender. Like that, RJ? Yeah, that's all right. Now, in order to have that first step, you need to be able to see the way the defender is coming at you. My favorite time to make a drive on a defender is normally when he's running out at me, because then his momentum is carrying him away from the hoop, and I can just go by him very easily.
Oh! He dunked it over the steroid pitch!
A lot of times when people show a little jab step is to see if the defender's going to go for the fake. You have to use that jab, and if you see he's not going to go for it, then that's when you make that long first step. And you got to put that first dribble out there to get by the guy. Now, if somebody is defending me straight up, sometimes I like to fake left and go right, fake right and go left. You just have to figure out which way will be best for you and your teammates. Once you get by the defender, it's just all about finishing right then and there. And whether you're going to finish with your left hand, your right hand, a dunk, a reverse layup, a short pull-up, then it just becomes, you know, whatever, however you want to finish them off. Okay, now, you learn to drive. You've learned the first step. You've learned everything there is in order to get to the hoop and finish it the right way. We'll save the dunk for the next lesson. See ya.
That's about all the time we have for today's show. We'll see you next week with more Inside Stuff.
So long, everybody.